So then, since I have been assigned to do this, do the message this morning, you're just going to have to put up with me.
Hello, sweetheart, and happy birthday to you.
Hi. So today we are here to celebrate my mom, Carolyn Lucille Scott, on her birthday, which is a very important day.
Happy birthday to the greatest mom in the whole wide world.
We are sending birthday greetings to my mom, Carolyn L. Scott. Happy birthday. I love
Happy
you
birthday.
Very much. And also Merry Christmas.
Yes.
And Happy New Year, because we won't be there for any of that.
Hello there, mother, from South Texas, to your youngest and greatest child. Making a video to tell you happy birthday. Had to have him in it because he wouldn't be quiet when I was trying to put him down. I love you so very much, and I hope you always, forever remember that and know that. You've just been a great mom to this family. You've been a great wife to my dad, and you know we all appreciate who you are in this family. And I, for one, have benefited from your love and your support, your encouragement, even though sometimes it comes across quite brisk. And sometimes abrasive. But in any case, you do it for my good. Sometimes I feel like you punk me out though.
If I ever hear of you selling so much as a cough drop, I'm coming down on you so hard.
And I get over it, though. I get over it. I'm pretty strong.
She is a mother who takes her job so, so seriously.
Mom, I love you with all my heart. So please don't rip it out.
It's very important to us, to her, as well as to us.
It's such a wonderful realization that God has blessed you with these magnificent years. And I want to tell you again, like I try to tell you all of the time, how much I really, really love you, and I thank God for you.
My mom is, first and foremost, a God lover. She loves God more than anything with her heart, her soul, and with her mind.
Forget it. The only Jesus I know is him. And the one thing he don't need is a partner.
And that's something that she's taught us. And we've taught our children, and we live by it every day. And she made sure that all of us love God and that we live a God-filled life.
You're precious to me. Even back in those days when we were just getting started, and I would send you flowers, or I would send you a card or a letter. Oftentimes I would sign it
I love you just because, dot, dot, dot. And I want to tell you that all of these years that we've been able to share our lives together, that those dot, dot, dots have become to mean so much to me. You've been a blessed wife, a wonderful mother to our children, and a tremendous minister of the gospel and example to other women and mothers.
My mama is a trip. I remember one time when she came to pick us up from clarinet practice down at cross from Wayne State at the music school. She's sitting out there, and this man got close to the car, and she could see in the rearview mirror. He's getting closer and closer. And rather than just pulling off, my mom jumps out of the car. Slams her hand down on top of the car, talking about, get your hand off of that car. Mama, you a trip.
You have that kind of passion, girl. When you believe what you believe it, and you hang in there with it, and you trust God to bring it to pass. So thank you for being my horseradish, red hot, cayenne pepper, passionate mama.
Hey, all right, so I got three, actually. I couldn't narrow it down to one. One is not necessarily a memory, but it's something I've learned that I wanted to share with everybody so they'll feel my pain. It's impossible to tell you no. I mean, you know, you ask me if I'm hungry, if I want some more, if you want me to, you know, you bring food that I don't want to eat, you know, or groceries that I don't want, or clothes you bought that I would never wear, you know, but I can't ever say no, so I just take them and just say okay, because I don't want to argue.
I don't know what story to tell. It's been a lot, from the times that you've stayed up late to help with homework, to your encouragement. I would almost say sneaky, because sometimes when you're teaching and you're being a mom and leading us into the right direction, you do it kind of sneaky, where it's like, you know, you want us to go in this one direction, but you don't say it outright, and then all of a sudden it feels like it's our idea. But I know, I'm on to you. I know that it was your idea from the start.
My mother is not pretentious.
That man is the most miserable, low-down, sneak, sliding, slick son I ever seen.
She's not gonna put on airs.
You must have had to start something to get something over. So if you done started something, I'm gonna get it over.
She lets you know who she is, and she doesn't apologize for it.
Why, you old bean-eating, beady-head, bad-hugging donkey.
And so that's one thing that has helped me become who I am.
One that comes to mind for me is when we had the late Women's Day lunch or brunch, I think it was, when you spoke about growing up on the farm and how you milked the cows and the cows, I don't know why you was laughing. The cows would kick the bucket over, and you use that to say how we tend to, you know, build up all this, you know, stamina, steam, or whatever you want to call it, and then we sabotage ourselves and kick our bucket over. And that really stuck with me. And now when I tell somebody, when I'm speaking to someone about that, I always bring up the cow and kicking your bucket over thing. So I appreciate that, and I love you for it. And I hope you have a happy, happy birthday. Merry Christmas.
So, five words to describe my mother. I don't know if five is enough or if it's too much. But let's start with thoughtful.
Passion. Oh, girl, you're so passionate.
Bold.
She is a nana. Not just a grandmother, but a nana.
Hi, Anna.
Stubborn would have to be one. We don't have to talk about that one, though.
She's caring.
Beautiful.
You are my chocolate diamond. That's two words, but it has one meaning.
Encouraging.
Think loving is another one.
Smart.
And she is real.
Love you. Say bye-bye.